For me, the best thing about Creative Computing Institute is the sense of community that we're creating. This is one of the few places in the world where you can see things from an arts perspective and also a science and technology perspective at the same time. And that means that together everyone is talking about something they can't really talk about anywhere else.
I studied at University of Arts London. I was like the techie person in like traditional design environments where maybe some of the things I needed or the spaces, the conversations I wanted to have did not exist. So when I knew that the CCI was being created, I was always trying to find ways on how I can get involved.
This is the first cohort of students in the program. I've been really impressed at how much they've taken the materials we've given them and made them their own.
Every time I come in the building, the students are just like chomping at the bit to show their work to people. I think it'll be a very, very good career for them.
So I'm showing my first project on the diploma. I thought it would be interesting to explore what if we could see in sound rather than light.
So I did the week-long machine learning course and the P5.js course with the CCI, and it's really helped me sort of develop my practice and teach me more of the development side of coding.
It's really changed my mind about like what computation is, what it means to the world, what it means like to society at large. Like, in the course of a year, I've like really changed how I'm thinking about it.
We have a beautiful mission and a great social agenda, and we really want to positively impact the way tech works in society.
I think of computing as a craft exercise, like pottery or weaving. It's going to take you a long time to become a master of it, but the first steps should be approachable by anyone. And I think that's an important part of what we do here at CCI.
Hello, everyone. Thanks for joining us on this open day session at the Creative Computing Institute. My name is Georgina, and I'm the Creative Learning Producer at CCI. And today we are here to look at the Diploma in Creative Computing course, both the Diploma for second year students at UAL and the Graduate Diploma. And we've got with us Joel Gethin Lewis, the main tutor at the Diploma, Vali Laliotti, the program director at CCI, a Diploma alumni, Max Zimmerer, and current student at the Diploma, Mara Nisia Cosleacara. To give you an overview of how the session is structured, we're going to talk a bit about the CCI first, where the campus is located, what resources and facilities are available to students. And then Vali and Joel will talk us through the approach and the unit of the Diploma in Creative Computing. After that, we're going to hear from students about their experience. And we're going to finish up the session with an open Q&A where we encourage you to write any questions you have about the course on the chat. And we'll do our best to keep an eye on all these questions coming through and to answer them at the last bit of the session during the Q&A. In terms of accessibility, just a note to say that the Blackboard Collaborate, which is the platform that we're using for today's session, doesn't display live captions. So if you have any difficulties following along the session, please know that we are recording this session at the moment, and we're gonna upload this video on YouTube, and we will send you a link so you can rewatch in case you miss any detail or you wanna just go through all the content again. It's all gonna be stored, and we're gonna send you the link. So let's get this started. We're gonna start now by watching a recorded video that I put myself together, which tells you a little bit more about the CCI and everything that will be available to you as a CCI student. Thanks everyone, and let's get this started. Hi everyone. In this video, we're going to show you around the campus and share some of the facilities and resources available to CCI students. The Creative Computing Institute is located at UAL's Peckham Road campus in Camberwell, South East London. The local area is home to a thriving art scene, which hosts a variety of art galleries and artist studios that students, graduates, and staff work and exhibit in. On site, there are two galleries, Camberwell Space and the Student Union Gallery, with the South London Gallery right next door and Peckham Platform in the local area. Also, on site, we have an amazing library supported by a dedicated CCI librarian who oversees the subject area of creative computing ensuring the library stays up to date with the books, periodicals, databases, and other resources you need to complete your studies. The CCI is located across the 4th and 5th floor of the newest building at Peckham Road, which means it's very accessible to students with various needs. Let's take a look around. The CCI is divided into four main areas. At the heart of the space is the kitchen. At lunchtime, it becomes a social hub of CCI for folks to share lunch together, and during classes, it's quite a working space. Along the side are three classrooms, two seminar rooms, and one high-end computer suite fitted with some of the latest technology, including 24 high-spec computers with NVIDIA RTX 2080 graphics cards and 4K monitors for working on projects ranging from machine learning to 3D rendering and video editing. Additionally, many of these computers can actually be accessed remotely from home after hours to enable access to specialist software or the high performance for rendering or machine learning work. In addition to the computing facilities, we have dedicated spaces set up for electronics, soldering, 3D printing, and virtual reality facilities. Elsewhere within the building, CCI students have access to the 3D workshop, which includes additional 3D printing facilities, laser cutting, CNC machining, and a full wood workshop. We take COVID-19 safety very seriously, so at the moment, our spaces are reconfigured to enable students to spread out 2 meters apart. There's also loads of windows to ensure good ventilation and hand and surface sanitizer throughout the space to keep things clean, on top of regular visits from cleaning staff. In normal times, we also operate a laptop locker system where students can borrow a laptop to use within the CCI spaces. This is just a glimpse of the amazing resources and facilities that are going to be available for you while studying at CCI. Now, I would like to briefly talk about the CCI social mission and public program. At CCI, we aim to integrate computational thinking with approaches to fairness and equality for the UAL and wider community. This is formally codified through our social mission, which focuses on diversity in technology, digital inclusion, and entrepreneurship. Our public program is underpinned by this mission and connects students, practitioners, and researchers with an international community of creative computing professionals. The aim of the public program is to offer a platform where UAL students, staff, and industry people can explore creative technology through workshops, public events, intensive courses, and fellowships awarded to practitioners in the field. To give you a sense of what you have the chance to take part in while studying at CCI, here are some of the programs that we've run. CCI's inaugural fellowship in 2018 was awarded to Feminist Internet. We run a series of workshops exploring the idea of a feminist Alexa. Our second fellowship was awarded to creativeapplications.net, in which we delved into creative coding with custom LED displays and innovative ways to apply to new technologies. CCI awarded its third fellowship to artist and researcher Anna Riddler. Together, we ran a learning program called Artificial AI, where we explored some of the problematics embedded in datasets. In parallel, we've run several week-long intensive courses open to all UAL students, which included inclusive design in wearable technology, designing a feminist chatbot, computational thinking with P5.js, machine learning for the creative industries, design with data and interactive machine learning, and the latest one we run, querying voice AI transcendental design. We also started the CCI After School Club, now renamed Tech Yard, a safe space aimed at young people, families, and beginners based in the local area in Peckham and Camberwell, who want to learn creative computing in a supportive environment. This is just a quick overview of all the opportunities that we've been able to provide to UAL and CCI students over the last 2 years. But there are so many exciting things that are on the way and that we cannot wait for you to take part in. Thanks so much for watching and listening. I hope you enjoyed what you just seen, and now let's keep moving. Hi again, I hope you found that useful. Now we're going to play a video that Vali Laliotti recorded for us, in which she shares some important bits about the Diploma in Creative Computing. So next up is Vali.
Hello, I'm Dr. Vali Laliotti, I'm the program director of the Creative Computing Institute. I'm also the acting course leader of the Diploma degree. I'm delighted to welcome you today in our open day event about the Diploma in Creative Computing. The Creative Computing Institute offers a variety of innovative courses and also research opportunities to explore how computer science and creative practice can come together. In this way, we are part of UAL that explores how technology is shaping our world, and it prepares you, the next generation of creative talent, to shape the world with technology. The Diploma course is an opportunity for students from across the UAL, from all types of creative disciplines, to add a material understanding of computational technologies and to use those technologies within different practices. It's an understanding also of how these kind of technologies create innovation both in the creative industries but also in art and design. It is also a great opportunity to network and work together with talent from across UAL and across many disciplines from art and design and performances. I'd like to show you this slide, which is a course overview. I'm only going to briefly talk about this because Joel will go in a lot more detail about what each unit looks like and what exciting things you're going to be learning and how. It's important just to show you this so that you understand the kind of structure that we follow. So we have a similar structure to other UAL courses with two blocks. And in the first block that spans across the first term and part of the spring term, you have three units with 20 credits for each unit. We have the first unit teaching you coding and the fundamental computing frameworks. Then the next unit is about artificial intelligence, and that builds both on coding artificial intelligence. It's not that hard. It's quite exciting to be able to do that because also it allows us to talk more academically and in terms of the impact on society. And then in the final part, you're going to be learning physical computing and also integrate your learning into your creative practice. It is the same rhythm that we will use in block two. So we will have you building up on your coding with looking at app development and learning that. And we will connect also your learning to what is happening outside in the industry. So we will have, if COVID allows, visits to creative practices and also guest speakers to talk a little bit more about how they use creative technologies in different disciplines. And finally, we will have more project-led work where you consolidate the two terms into a creative practice around computational environments. So this way, we allow you to learn and then also practice in a very similar way to what a creative studio will do, and similar to what you used also in your current courses. In terms of assessment, because that's always a question, we also have different types of assessment so that it fits different styles of learning. For example, in the more coding units, we will have some tests around coding. So you might be answering multiple choice questions, or you might be writing a piece of code. And that is one part of assessing. In another part of assessing, for example, in artificial intelligence, would be reading academic papers and journals and writing an essay around your thinking and of artificial intelligence. And finally, you have the more creative practice modules and units where you could do mini projects, and you can be tested around those. I hope you are excited about this. Joel will just go into a lot more detail on what you will be doing in every unit. And also we have alumni and students. So in the Q&A session, we're gonna interview them and you can ask questions of me, Joel, and our students and alumni. Thank you.
Thanks, Vali, for this lovely video. That was very useful to hear. So now I would like to invite Joel to join us live so he can share some more detail about how the diploma is taught and its units. So Joel, over to you.
Hello, everyone. Are you receiving me? Is this coming in? Can you hear me? If someone could just say in the chat if they can hear me. Can you hear me? Am I being received?
We can hear you, Joel, yeah. Hopefully Cindy's can yes.
Jane, yes. Alex, yes. Fantastic. This is the first step to all interactions. Feedback loops. I love it. Okay. So I'm going to start off taking on from what Vali introduced so beautifully there about this this fantastic course, the Diploma in Creative Computing at the CCI. Let me just share a screen for you, and then I can take you through a little bit of the structure. Hopefully you lot out there can see this. Can you see this? Is this coming through? Yes, I think I can see it. I can see it. It's coming through. Excellent, excellent. This is the web page that I'm showing you now, just in case any of you want to bookmark that, set it as your home page, whatever you like. I'm going to take you through a little bit more detail of the structure. One thing to say is that one of the reasons that I am so excited to be the head tutor on the diploma is because I'm really interested in adding creative computing practice to someone that already has a practice at UAL. And all of you that are in the chat right now, I believe, are already on UAL courses. If you could just type in and say like which degree you're on, that would be super interesting for me, and I'm sure we can start the kind of conversation off about that afterwards. So oh, you're not, Jane. Okay, well, we can get you going at a degree here at UAL, and then you can come and do the BSc at Creative Computing. So there's other options available, so you can't escape. You're already in. It's happening. We've got, who have we got? We've got Selin on fine art sculpture. We've got Neil on fine art as well. Fantastic. One of the things that I'm excited about, and the reason that I came to teach at the diploma, Jane, you don't have to be. You could do the BSc in creative computing. So we can have a chat about that in the kind of general chat after I do this introduction. One of the things to show as an option here is that a fully online mode is available, and we expect that still to be available next year, as next academic year as well. And the reason that I was so excited to teach on this on this course and be the head lecturer on it is because I'm really excited about the possibility of not just teaching people how to code. Like that's not the primary purpose of this diploma. We're going to teach you to code. Of course, we're going to do that. But what I'm really interested in is actually using these kind of computational techniques to be actual useful techniques for any practice at all. And as we all know, in the 21st century, computing and creative computing is touching every part of pretty much every creative practice out there. So it's a really exciting area to be in. Some of the reasons to apply interdisciplinary teaching, the material understanding of computational technologies, as Vali already said about that. It's research-informed teaching, right? So the research that's going on here at the Institute feeds into that, and hopefully we can talk about that with some of the previous students and the students who are in it right now. And also this particularly important part, right? That one of the reasons that the CCI is so important to me is that we're trying to get a critical conversation going about technology, right? We're trying to avoid that kind of Jurassic Park cliche of scientists and technicians making things just because they were wondering if they could, not thinking about if they should. So we've already had a look at the facilities, and Vali's talked a little bit about this breakdown of units that happen. So as she said, there's these three units per block, and there's two blocks per year. So each block takes up a term and a half. It took me a bit of time to get my head around it as well. I'm sure if any of you are at UAL already, you're familiar with the block structure. Unit one is taught by me. It's all about creative coding and creative computing frameworks. And this is really the kind of core computer science knowledge of the first block. So I'm going to introduce you to various different programming techniques, really concentrating around JavaScript and P5.js, which is a library I'll talk about in a second. And then unit two, which is taught by Alex and Rebecca, which is all about introducing computational futures and artificial intelligence. So this is a kind of combination, as Vali mentioned, of learning machine learning techniques, but also querying and critically engaging with the use of machine learning and artificial intelligence in our whole society. And that's only going to increase in the future. The final unit, which is being taught by Indra, is all about visual coding and physical computing. So this is your chance to kind of go beyond the screen and really engage with hardware platforms like Arduino, Microbit. I think there's a bit of Raspberry Pi programming going on as well. Really getting out into the physical world, making things that move, using different techniques like weaving and other things like that to make textile technologies, all different kinds of possibilities there. Then that group of core lecturers will then mirror over into the second block, where unit four, which is coding for collaborative app development, this is where I'm going to teach you how to make apps for phones, likely concentrating around Apple iOS and Swift. And then the second unit of the second block is again taught by Alex, and this really draws on his experience as a practitioner. So this is another thing that's very exciting about the course, is that all of the lecturers on the course aren't just teaching, they're actually practicing out there in the real world, as it were, outside of the university. And then finally, unit six is particularly exciting to me. This is the experience of where we did some physical computing in unit three. In unit six, we're now going to do some computational environment work. So we're going to be moving into things like projection mapping, using cameras to be able to see, thinking about spaces on a kind of much wider, even up to architectural scale. As Vali also mentioned, there's a whole selection of different assessment methods that we use on the course. So for my units one and four, it's mainly exam based and multiple choice tests. And then for units two and five, Alex's units, they're assessed around essays and writing. And then units three and six, which are taught by Indra, are all about actual project work. So you're going to work along a project for the whole series of the block and then present that along with a video and some other documentation at the end of those units. So hopefully that's given you a little impression of how the course is structured and the different units that go into making that up. I'm going to close this one down now. So I'm going to give you a bit more detail on unit one, which is the first unit that I teach as head tutor. Let me just share the screen for that one. I'm juggling multiple Chrome tabs at the moment. It's very exciting. Okay, here we go. Okay, so this is the GitHub page of unit one. So this is a publicly accessible web page, so I'll put that into the chat as well. If any of you actually want to take a look at the course materials that you're going to be very likely engaging with next academic year, you can take a look there. And here I detail the kind of the layout of the unit itself. Of course, we've been doing a lot of sessions remotely in this kind of blended learning model that UAL's adopted over the last year. Hopefully, fingers crossed, next academic year we'll all be back there in person. But even if we aren't, I think we'll have some testimony that we can make things happen remotely, as in using a lot of interactive technologies to do that. I've got this code of conduct that I like to emphasize, inspired by Golan Levin. I go through a bit of the block and unit structure here. I've also got some kind of a breakdown of how the unit is structured. Also, this teaching style that we use on all the courses, which is a flipped classroom style, where we actually deliver lectures in video form that you can review out of class time, and we spend as much time as we can in person actually discussing and working through problems together. That's really important to me. As I said before, assessment for Unit 1 is based around multiple choice tests and practical exams, and then essays for Unit 2 and 5, 3 and 6 for videos and PDF. We've also got these exercises that are all based around this fantastic new book that's about to be published. This is one of the advantages of having this great group of lecturers and tutors on the course. We're actually in conversation with Golan Levin and Tiga Brain, two colleagues of ours from who teach over in the States, and they've given us access to some exercises from their upcoming fantastic book, Code as a Creative Medium. And then here's a breakdown of the entire course. I'm not going to talk you through all of this, but what I thought would be useful was to give you, have I got some time? How much time have I got? I'm meant to be going through the diploma show now, aren't I? Okay, I'm going to do one more minute on this, and then we can go over to the student experience. So I get permission. I'm getting thumbs up from Georgina. This is making me very happy indeed. Okay, so I'm going to share the actual introductory lecture or some parts of that just to give you guys an impression. Sorry, I'm not saying you guys, I'm saying you lot, because guys is a sexist term. As students will be able to testify, I've been trying to get myself out of that habit this term. Okay, I'm going to share the application or screen, and I'm going to share lecture 0. So this was the actual lecture that I gave this year as an introductory session. I'll post it up there as well if any of you want to review that after the fact. This is an hour-long lecture, so I'm not going to take you through all of it, but what I wanted to show you was actually to break through some of the general methods for succeeding in this course and in general. So here's a little bit about my background. We can talk about that later. Here's some introduction to the CCI, some of the languages that we're going to be using, how I'm going to structure the course, and what I think computational thinking is. Talking about some formulas for computer art, dimensions of time, and engaging with different lecturers around the world. But this is the thing that I wanted to show, and this is the thing that I'm going to discuss a little bit later, hopefully with the students, is these are my kind of selection of 13 things to keep in mind for the whole course and also in general for your lives. And this is the most important one of all. Okay, this is the most important one. We're going to make this interactive. So I'm just going to ask in the chat now, what does Dory do, everyone? Does anyone know what Dory does? Has anyone seen the Fantastic Finding Nemo, or the fantastic sequel to that, Finding Dory? No one's typing yet. This is depressing. Georgina, you're not allowed to cheat and type in. Is anyone going to do it? Yes! Oh, Mara, she's the current student. That's not fair. Okay, but yeah, she keeps swimming. And I think that's the most important thing to realize, and that's the most important thing that I'm trying to teach you on this course, quite apart from computational knowledge, quite apart from being critical about the use of computation in our society. The most important thing I want to teach you is resilience. Okay, I'm here to give you tools to enable you to establish a sustainable practice for yourself, to be able to return to your BA in your third year at UAL, but also to give you a springboard to think about how you can practice in the future and how you can do that in a sustainable way. I'm going across my time already. I'm being very naughty. Georgina's being very patient with me. But just to finish up with, what I'd like to show is a very, very short excerpt from the Diploma show. So this was the show that we did this summer, 2020, which was a completely online show. And we actually collaborated as a whole group of students and tutors to work with some other code that was generously donated from the team over at Carnegie Mellon in the States. And we customized this platform to make the wonderful, extraordinary CCI Diploma Show 2020. And you can see it right here. I'm going to share it in the chat as well. So if any of you would like to have a go, you can explore your way around. I'm going to join it right now. Here's my name, Joel. And we actually made a pixel art version of the entire experience at Camberwell. So here we are. I can go in. I can go into the reception. How's it going, Joel? Click the projects to view them. This is our AI bot here, aka security. We've got a whole map of so many different installations and experiences that the students made. I'm not going to be able to go through all of them, but let's just have a little look around. Let's go into the food room. I fancy some food. I'm hungry right now. What do we have? We have some kitchen dreams here. Time to eat a bun. What's this one? A simple screen game in which one becomes a lizard running on a red rock. Use your phone flashlight. Your task is to eat as many bugs as possible for watching out for predators. Well, I'm going to leave that to you guys to try it for yourself. Sorry, you lot. You see, I'm trying to capture, get this out of myself. If I walk through here, I can go up into the care room. And here we have a whole series of other projects here. You can go up into the animal room as well. A website for dog lovers, a place to lose yourself in a variety of doggy experiences. You can wear a dog crown, draw psychedelic dogs with your nose, or play a game of eat the treats using your dog head hoop to catch the dog biscuits. This is amazing. Okay, I'm going to paste that directly into this so you can see what I'm actually doing here. Let's play. Okay, I would like a dog crown. Okay, I'm going to allow it to use my camera. Do I look dashing in my doggy crown? Look at that. What a beautiful doggy crown that is. Extraordinary. Okay, I've gone way over in my time, as I always do. Georgina's been extremely patient with me. But now I think there's an opportunity to have a little chat about the student experience and alumni opportunity. So I'm going to hand back to the group.
Amazing. Thank you. That was an amazing presentation. I would love to invite Vali and Max and Mara over to the space. If you want to turn on your cameras and mics, amazing. We can start the conversation.
Hello.
Hello.
And enjoy. Hello.
Thanks for joining us.
So I'm Vali. You probably recognized me from the video. I'm joined here by two fantastic students. One alumni from last year, Max, and also Mark, who is a student this year. And thank you both for your time today, for joining here. And I'd like, because I wasn't here last year, Max, I just joined in October this year. So I would love to hear a little bit about what brought you to CCI and to the diploma degree, and how was your experience last year?
Okay. Like Vali said, I'm one of the diplomats from last year. And I still study graphic design at Central St. Martin's. And I basically, last year was the first year where the diploma was offered to students at UAL. And me and a group of people from the GCD course sort of decided to join the CCI because we wanted to get ahead on just coding and creative computing, and the CCI seemed to make it very approachable, which was the main reason why we all joined. And it turned out to be a really, really good experience overall. Joel sort of gave a short overview of what the course was like. And in the beginning, you sort of get introduced to very basic computer science concepts and JavaScript and p5.js, which are really good libraries and ways to get started on with code in general. And then later on, we were also introduced to AI, and sort of that helped us to form a stance on the whole topic. And then later on, we made our own projects and were able to creatively actually make stuff with the things we've learned prior. And yeah, overall, it was a good experience.
Great. Thanks very much, Max. And I was wondering, when you started learning some of that more, what did you do with all this experience? What was your project like during that year?
Yeah. The first project we all did was an audio reactive project. So the brief was sort of quite open in that way. It was basically we had to make something audio reactive in real time, and that allowed for a lot of stuff to happen. It was really interesting how people from different courses and different creative backgrounds approach the brief. We sort of learned the basics of JavaScript before that, and sort of had a range of tools that we could use to make the project happen. And it was really interesting because you sort of learned as you went along with the project and sort of tried to fulfill the brief. And there was sort of like always a weekly weekly meeting with everyone from the course where you could reflect on your progress, and then you sort of always got feedback which sort of guided you and helped you move forward. And at the end of the project, everybody had, there was like a really nice range of work and different approaches to the brief, which was really interesting to see. And that was the first brief that we all did. And it sort of forced us to kind of, for some of us more than others, probably to step out of our comfort zones and sort of do something that we've never done before. And that was probably the most valuable thing that we took away from the course. I think I'm also speaking for other people or other diplomats, but yeah.
Yeah, and I think you point out very well that the one thing that is very important to me that I'm very happy and made me join also the Creative Computing Institute, which is this ability to work from people with across different creative practices. And it sounds that that is a very rich environment, and especially in diploma where we have such a variety and diversity of creative practices. Meaning, what did you do on your final project? What was your topic that you felt passionate about to work more on?
Yeah, well, the final project was sort of it was interesting because of the pandemic, the main focus of our final project sort of shifted throughout. And before, we were sort of focusing on more local things, like a local interaction that was dealing with computer vision. And I think that's what I was doing. I'm not sure if that was the brief I was on. But later on, we sort of switched to web development because all of us were sort of spread all across the world. And we had to make something with socket connections, which means that we had to make things that works with two different people interacting in real time or more than two. It didn't really matter. And yeah, the main approach that I took was sort of similar to the first project. You sort of go along and learn as you make and sort of find the tools and learn the tools that you need to have to actually make the project happen. And I sort of was really interested in computer vision at the time and also face tracking. And that's something that Joel has introduced to us before. And I sort of already knew sort of the basics of what I needed to do. And I wanted to sort of just merge people's faces in real time, which was a pretty basic concept, but it took quite a long time to actually make it happen and sort of put all of those individual pieces of code and technical things together to make it work. But yeah, in the end, I made like a sort of like a web app that takes two live camera feeds.
It is totally awesome. I'm not going to let him talk it down. It's completely amazing. You go to this website and it swaps your face with someone else's face in real time. Yeah. And yeah. Max was just so determined. And even though it wasn't, as he said, we went away from what we were meant to be doing at the beginning of everything. We were meant to be doing things with open frameworks and doing all this stuff in person. But then the plague came and we had to kind of react to that and then develop all these other skills around making multiplayer kind of caring interactions and all this kind of stuff. But I think Max completely nailed it in terms of he leapt straight into the idea of practice, which I think is really important, which is getting used to the idea that you're going to be learning for the entirety of your life. And what I'm really trying to get people into the mentality of is giving themselves tools so that they can learn about anything and they not have to be intimidated by technical words or that computing isn't for them, that we give you the tools to be able to build things up on your own and use the amazing resources that are out there. I'm sorry I interrupted, but I knew Max would be very polite about his own project, but I couldn't let it happen. I couldn't let it happen, Max. Max, is it still live? Can you put it up in the chat for some people to give it a go?
Yeah, it's still okay. Live. Awesome. It's okay awesome. If I do it later because I don't have it. I'll do it once.
Yeah, yeah, you do it. Do it later. Do it later.
Yeah. Okay. But
yeah. Excellent.
Yeah,
I think that it is quite amazing. If you think of your cohort being the first one that did the diploma degree, and then in the middle of it, you had to rethink everything and make everything online. And I think the ability of computer and creative computing to give you that flexibility was quite positive, but also the amazing work that you've done as students and with staff to make it to get through to a very successful show. It is something also, the last question I think I'll ask you, no, the one before last, is something that very often people that are interested in the course are asking, is what did you do, who made with it after? So what, how did the diploma help you now that you're finishing your degree and maybe even later when you go into practice, into the bigger world?
Well, I think the main thing is basically that you're getting introduced to this whole broad range of tools and techniques, which basically, like for me personally, I was strictly very much into graphic design before, like traditional just graphic design, branding. But once you sort of get introduced to JavaScript, open frameworks, and just basically all these languages and form some sort of understanding about them, it completely opens up a new way to execute on your ideas. And I think that it's very important that, I think it's very valuable that you gain this technical ability, because it informs your practice completely differently than it did before. So now I personally started developing an interest for web development and obviously making websites, but then also using code to make real-time interactions happen. And I think that this not only sort of pushed the way I approach design in general, but then also allowed me to sort of expand the way I interpret graphic design, if that makes sense. Overall, I think just learning or forming an understanding of all the tools that are out there sort of allows you to make things in a crazy different way, like, if that makes sense.
It does, very much. So it sounds like not only you took it all, but you were able to really enrich your practice in ways that you haven't thought before, and in crazy ways, which is, I love to hear that, in ways that are innovative there and unusual. I did ask you one thing just before. I was wondering what was the best thing or a highlight of your time through the diploma and through the pandemic and through that year. That was an extraordinary year.
Well, the good thing about it was that once you entered the course, everybody was sort of on a level playing field, at least technically. People are all new to coding and computing in general. And like I said, there's people from all across UAL and creative backgrounds coming into one place, and it sort of becomes this creative melting pot. And it's really interesting to see how people sort of use code and use the things they learn to actually make things, and how their actual practice informs what they do. And I think the best things was always the sessions where everyone was sort of together and you were able to talk about the progress you've made, sort of presenting projects to other people and sort of just constantly exchanging ideas and getting feedback from others, which really, really helped in the creative process overall. But then you sort of also build up a community, and it's a very healthy and positive working environment. And I think those interactions were very, very valuable. And that was probably the main thing.
Great. Max, thanks very much. Stay with us because there will be questions. Thanks very much for your time today. And I'd like to introduce Mara, who is our current student, been only with us like for a month and a half. Already. So Mara, tell us a little bit about what made you come to the diploma? What made you join the degree?
So it's actually a really funny story, because I think that it's one of the most random decisions of my life. But last year, I found out about this short course that the CCI had, computational thinking with P5GS. And after going to the CCI for a week learning stuff, I was amazed by the opportunities you have with computing. And before this, I was doing painting at Camberwell. So I was this art-loving, literature, history-loving person. I thought that everything that is related to computing is like a complete opposite from all of my interests. And then I've been in the Creative Computing Institute for a week, and I was so amazed about the amount of things you can do with computing and how it can be creative and artsy and all that. So I thought that if I actually understood a tiny bit of computing in 1 week and I made some really cool P5GS sketches, what could I do in an entire year? So I just applied, and it's been so far so great.
Fantastic. I'm very glad that your intuition led you to the right place for this. So you're saying the experience is nice. What particular things you might enjoy? Can you give me some highlights of this year, a month and a half? I know it's not very long.
I think it's been a lot of things. For the beginning, I think it was just the challenge, because I've never done coding before, and it was so nice to actually have all of these challenges and learning all the time new things. I feel like my brain is going to explode from all of the stuff that I learned, and I feel so happy to try all of these different things and learn all the possibilities that we can have. And I think one of the highlights was discovering how I can love things that I think that I hated. For instance, in the physical computing thing with the Arduino thing, is basically based on like electricity and circuits and stuff. And I hated physics my entire life, and now I play every day with this thing. I just have it here and I love it. It's so cool. And I think this is the best part of the course, like starting to love things that you think you hate.
Oh, that's amazing. That, thank you, Mara, so much. I think we will coach you now. Yeah, I mean, physical computing and coding is just a big love of me, and it's wonderful to see, you know, that we managed to pass that love and passion over to our students as well. I think probably Georgina was very kind not to interrupt us, but I think we're approaching the time of actually opening up to our students to ask, to people participating to ask questions. Georgina, should we hand it over to you?
Thanks, everyone, for your presentations. Yes, it would be lovely if everyone who's here with us in this virtual room wanted to just share any comments or questions that you have about the course, about the campus, life at UAL, life at the diploma, whatever that crosses your mind. We're here to cover that. So we have one question from Alex. They're saying, please, I want to ask you a short question. If I would make a sandwich year coming from fine art sculpture, I can learn to program LED text and VR?
So that's yes.
Probably for Joel, yeah?
I think one of the things that's important to realize.
I can talk about VR as well.
Okay, cool. I think one of the things that's important to realize is that we really want to introduce you to like a basic set of skills. And then the idea is that you can specialize, right? That you can engage with the practice that makes sense to you. So if you want to, in the physical computing stuff, make a bunch of LED text stuff and some scrolling text things or other fantastical drones with LED lights on that go off to space, all this, that's all completely possible. And it's great, Alex, that you already have directions that you want to go in. We really encourage that. For the VR stuff, I do some basic stuff in JavaScript with this platform called A-Frame, which is great for VR, really close, easy to get into. But I should definitely refer to Vali, because she is a VR genius in terms of actually making projects that are working right now with really high-end VR systems. So what would you say, Vali?
Now that you build me up so much, Joel, I don't know, it's only downhill from here.
I realize, by the way, I've got a halo here. This is very exciting.
But it's true, VR, virtual reality, is something I've been working on since it started 15, 20 years ago, when we still had projection-based virtual reality and big expensive systems. And now, of course, I'm working with headsets and so on. So it's really quite exciting. We have, you know, the facilities for that to happen, and we're expanding on that. Currently, I'm building a project which was funded by Innovate UK, and this is about supporting musicians to be able to rehearse and perform in virtual reality, especially to support them during this really difficult time of the pandemic and the lockdown. And they perform as if they are in a real venue, inside a concert hall, and with the acoustics of the concert hall. So it's quite an exciting project, and there is also one more project that it comes in terms of research. So there is this interesting combination and interaction between the research that we're doing as staff, as academics, and how we pass this on special projects with our students. So expect a lot of that to come through within the diploma as well.
Amazing, thanks both. We have another question about how many students we can take into the diploma and if it is available for anyone who is interested.
Should say a yes, a very clear yes. We are actually in a very fortunate position where we doubled the number of students. And of course, that means that we are growing also in terms of faculty, in terms of people that are teaching. And also we have this approach where we split into smaller groups. So it's not the whole cohort in one go. We actually have a way of managing this into splitting groups, smaller groups, where, of course, we can teach effectively.
My aim is, like the virus that is currently plaguing the world, I want to go exponential on the number of students on the diploma. We did 30 the first year, we've got 60 going now. I want 120 the year after and 240 after that. I'm going to keep on doubling until my brain explodes. So we've got some time to go. I think there's a good question here from Selin about what's the process of us applying to join the diploma?
Yes, so I can answer that myself. We're in the process of putting together a form where you'll be able to just share your interest and do the application. So just so you know, there's going to be two rounds of applications. There's going to be one ending at the end of term one, so that will be around end of March. And we're going to have a late application cycle, which is going to end at the end of the academic year, so that will be in June. As I said, that's not gonna go through the UCAS system, so that's an independent platform. So we're gonna send an email after this session to everyone who attended, where I'm gonna be able to share the link so you can apply if you wish to, and also on social media and all the UAL channels. That will also be something that we will be sharing. So that's just gonna be an online form where you can apply directly. So yeah, we'll be in touch with further details soon, hopefully.
I also wanted to say, and a great way of getting a taste of what the experience of the diploma and the BSc, which is the three-year option, or the MSc, which is postgraduate, and our research programs and all that kind of thing as well, is to take a look at the link I've just put up into the chat, which is the short courses that we offer as part of CCI as well. I believe, Mara, did you have a little experience of a short course as well? So I think that's, and I think Max, did you have experience of my lectures that I was doing at GCD?
Yeah.
So basically what I've been doing over the last couple of years is doing short courses and lecture courses around creative computing across all of UAL, and I'm going to continue doing that. So if I'm coming to one of your colleges, please take the opportunity to engage with me. The other thing to do is the short courses, which Georgine does a lot of work on, a really amazing bite-sized 5-day high intensity courses that you can take over the summer or other periods to get a really good impression of what your experience and life at CCI is like.
Amazing, thank you all. We have another question about funding. Who would be able to cover how the funding process works for diploma students? Because I guess that's an extra year of funding, right?
Yeah, as far as I know, Vali, do you know the answer to this?
Yes, of course, you can apply for student loans, and that can continue if you already are a student, so this is covered. But also there is a specific hardship fund which you could tap into, especially because we appreciate that sometimes we need really good infrastructure for you to be able to follow. So that will support towards a laptop and equipment that you might need for online sessions, like a microphone, for example. So there is a lot of support, and of course you could apply across other paths, but there is specific UAL hardship support that you tap into.
But you can always use your student finance. I know for me it was pretty easy to get an extra year of funding from them.
I think this is one of the things that's really lovely about the diploma, is because you're already within the UAL family, it's actually a really easy thing to do in terms of going along the routes of funding that you've already got to support you on the course. Of course, you have to have an extra year of time in London, which isn't the cheapest city in the world, but by that point, you're already 2 years into your experience within the UAL family. And so you should be in a good position to be able to add on an extra year there. And that's certainly been the response from a lot of students last year and this year, is they really saw it as a way of being flexible and responding to the changing world that is changing very rapidly as we speak, but a great way of adding that creative computing to any of the things that you're already studying at UAL. And I think that's one of the reasons that the diploma is such a strong course, and it's going to continue to be a strong course and grow into the future.
Lovely. We haven't received any other questions, so please feel free to do so. We have 4 minutes left for this session, so this is your chance to share any questions you have. Yeah, otherwise, is there anything else you would like to cover or share, Max, Mara? Any other thoughts, suggestions, recommendations?
You have to come and do the course to find out why I'm holding a rubber duck here. And anyone who's been on the diploma knows exactly why the rubber duck is so important. So yes, you have to try.
And we have to tell girl that they will also have one rubber duck when they join.
Yes, everyone gets a free rubber duck. There we go. free rubber duck with every diploma.
Together with, of course, some of the kids we provide for the advocate that Mara was holding with all the different circuits and so on. That is part also of something that comes with courses.
Amazing. We have another comment from Alex about, hopefully that applying after the UK leaving Europe. Hopefully, yes, that won't be an issue for now. Amazing.
Any other questions? Come on, who hasn't asked a question? I'm going to be pretending like I am in the lectures when I can see.
3 minutes left.
Neil, you haven't asked. Ika, I'm sorry if I pronounced your name wrong. I think Alex has already asked a question. Celine has asked a question. Jane Norris had to leave, unfortunately. Okay, there we go. Yes. If we need help with coding and physical computing without being part of CCI, and can we still reach out for any help? Yes. We are here at the Creative Computing Institute to help with that engagement across the UAL campuses, all across London, and in general, we're advocates of creative computing. So Ike, if you want to reach out to us, there's an email that you're going to get, I believe, automatically at the end of this anyway, and that'll have ways of getting in contact. If you need to get in contact via email, you can of course drop us an email, but also you can get in contact with UAL CCI via the email address that Georgina has just thrown into the chat. It's almost like we're psychically linked. It's extraordinary. On top of that as well, you can always reach out through social channels. So we've got a very strong Instagram presence. We've got a very strong Twitter presence. Any questions you've got at all, drop us a tweet or a gram, and then we can have a chat and get it sorted out from there. But that's really something that we're keen to be part of, is the wider creative computing community. So thanks for that question.
It's the same for graduates.
This is the thing, right? As a diplomat, you're going to be a diplomat forever now. You can't escape. And so one of the things that's actually really powerful about this process is that after you've graduated, you're still going to have access to all the techniques and communication methods and the forums that we have internally. So this is actually kind of building up in power, going exponential again. And I'm hoping that the network effects of all these amazing diplomats going out into the world will then produce extra extraordinary companies, which is what we need if we're going to survive the 21st century. Not going to end on a downer. We can do this. We can do this.
Of course we can. Amazing. Okay, I think we just came to an end here. Thanks
Neil's
everyone
gonna
for
apply.
Joining
Neil's
us.
Neil's going to apply. Excellent.
Yes. Yeah. Okay, we look forward to receiving your application. Amazing.
Yeah, looking forward to see you guys next year. It's going to be awesome.
Yay.
Thanks so much for being in the chat and participating, everyone. I'm going to say good evening. I'm going to go and get myself a nice mug of Earl Grey tea, and all I have left to say is live long and prosper, and I hope to see you all.
Yes, thanks everyone. You'll receive a follow-up email in a few days with the recording as well.
Thanks, Georgina.
Thanks all for joining us.
Bye, you're welcome, Georgina. Bye.
Bye.
Yeah, bye.